Hi there, Virgo Libra. Welcome into your reading. So today we're having a little Patreon request to do some career readings, and we're going to look at your current energy in that area, some obstacle that you may be facing, and some advice, and then where you're headed to, and some timing, okay? So if you're interested in having access to these readings and a lot of more exclusive content, this was going to be one of those exclusive contents, but I ended up deciding to post it here on YouTube too. But if you're interested, the link is going to be down below. And let me just charge my computer. There we go. And let's get started here with your overall energy. Oh my goodness. Hang in there. This is way too much. Slow your horses. Okay. For my Virgo Libra, what do we got? All right. So, bottom of deck, we have Forge. Don't follow. This might be one of my favorite cards. Pave a new path. Be the leader you wish you had. And then we have the Seas of Mintaka. Seeing potential, bringing in consciousness to light. We have this water your garden, nourishment, body care, tenderness, and rest. We have karmic relationships, Orient energy, polarity, soul growth in conflict. And then finally we have I remember, so plan the fated life versus the destiny life. There was this workshop that I was doing about books, and one thing, there was this one sentence that kind of lines up what books are and not only books but also life, which is without friction there's no fiction. And so what this kind of lines up with life and human beings is that without conflict there is no growth, without struggle there is no light at the end of the tunnel, right? Without darkness there is no light. It's the duality of things and how we need both of them to thrive and to make our dreams a reality, essentially. So I feel like right now we need to work with duality here. I feel like for this card to show up, water your garden, you may be doing a bit too much, and it's time for us to go to the other duality and rest a bit. We have some really interesting things astrologically happening in the next few months, and I feel like especially Mercury and Mars retrograde is going to be a bit of a tricky time. And I feel like it's important for you to be fully recharged when it comes to that time, okay? It will also be a great time for you to rest then, but life goes on, right? So if you can, you know, even just take a weekend off and breathe and just enjoy yourself, have fun. You know, I feel like that is important because I feel like you are in this period of this soul growth, of this conflict. And again, it comes hand in hand, okay? And I feel like you need a moment to just see the conflict and think of the solution and not focus on that conflict and that you are having struggles and that kind of thing. Okay, so we need to work on dualities. We need to see the conflict to see the solution. We need to rest so then we can do more. Okay, and I feel like you're kind of on the opposite sides, and that is where they're trying to get to you, right? So right now you may be doing a lot and it's time to rest. It's time to lead into the period of rest. Right now you may be super focused on the conflict, but it's time to see the solution. Okay, and this is all part of the progress and the process to get to this soul plan and fate of life, destiny of life, and all those things. Okay, because you do have potential, and I feel like you are on this new path, and you are on this, you know, new doors. Things are happening, but as counterintuitive as that might sound, or I don't know, as weird as that may sound, you need to stop. Instead of doing more to create these new beginnings, you need to fall back and let your guides take care of the rest, okay? I feel like that is the period that we are in right now. It's really embracing the darkness. It's really embracing this mirror period of stillness. And just to hold our breaths, let the universe handle stuff, and then, okay, I can finally move, okay? So I feel like that is essentially it. We are moving, we are focused on conflict, and we need to take a step back and rest so we can see the solution. Okay, I hope this is making sense. Maybe I'm just talking nonsense and not making any sense, but that's me. But let's get here some tarot for you and see what we got. Alrighty. And we have the deck, like, wanting to move very quickly. Let's see. So we have the Five of Swords in your current energy. We have the Three of Swords in your obstacle. Your advice is the Knight of Swords. And then where we are headed is the Chariot and the Eight of Pentacles. So let me just pull one more card for this Five of Swords. So many cards, Jesus. That is the thing. I feel like you're being asked to do, like, hey, go archive those files. And you archive the files, you clean the room, you switch the light bulbs, and you clean every single piece of paper that you put in it. You know, you're just being asked to file the archives, okay? To archive the files, right? So you're just being asked to do that. Just do that, right? I feel like there's not necessarily pressure, but I feel like there's this big desire to get things moving. And sometimes that builds up pressure and that builds up, I don't know, tension, and it constricts the energy, and the energy needs room to expand and to flow, okay? So let's see, one card for this Five of Swords. We have the Ace of Cups. That is the thing. I feel like there is this feeling of, I don't know, I feel like you want this new beginning, but I feel like you're doing anything you can. The Five of Swords kind of talks about that. Like, you want a win, and you do anything it takes to have that win, right? Even if you have to kill people or that kind of thing, you do it. And I feel like that's kind of what is going on here right now. It's like you want this new beginning with all your heart. And yes, work hard and go after the things, but that is a bit outdated. It's not that you have to slack and not do anything. No, but it's about thinking long term and not thinking immediate success. And I need to have this today, right? Because things need time to grow. And I feel like right now you're trying to pressure something to grow and pressure something to open up, doors to open up for you and opportunities to open up for you when it's not the time. So I feel like you're being asked to breathe, slow down, right? And I feel like this is coming perhaps from this place of the Three of Swords, of you having a fear of being disappointed, having a fear of things not working. You're focused, again, on the conflict and on the possibility of conflict instead of figuring out, okay, how can I not create conflict? Right now, especially right now, today, at this moment, as I'm breathing. Okay? And I feel like the answer here and the advice is coming through this Knight of Swords. I feel like it's, first of all, realizing this Three of Swords, realizing the fears and the wounds that are behind it and healing it, taking time to do it, build the confidence, build this trust in your spirit guides, and do know that you are headed towards success and you are going to have a lot of work to do there, right? But right now, you don't have a lot of work, you know, in a matter of speech. Maybe you do, but right now, you don't have a lot. How to phrase this? I feel like here you're going to have a lot of things to do and a lot of movement. Right now, if there's not movement, don't create movement. Okay? I hope I'm making sense. Essentially, let's recap this. Essentially, what is going on is that you are manifesting new beginnings. You are manifesting new opportunities. But to get there, you need to stop and slow down. It's not by rushing through things that you're going to get there. It's not by pressuring things that you're going to get there. You need to rest. You need to prepare yourself for when the opportunity actually comes. You need to be open to your intuition and listen to it. You need to be receptive to the conflict and to the struggles so you can learn from that and get more knowledge. You need to stay exactly where you are. And let the universe and life take you there. Don't force a path. Let the path show to you. Okay? I really hope I'm making sense. I feel like I'm talking a lot of I don't know, random words. But essentially, you are manifesting those beginnings. Don't pressure them. Okay? So let's see here. Some advice for you. We have adapt. There we go. You will get yourself where you want to be. I wouldn't be surprised if patience would be here. It's actually not. We have joy. Make time for the little things today. We have serenity. Value quiet days with only the rustling leaves breaking the silence. And potential. The littlest key can open the heaviest door. And I feel like you're trying to open the heavy door with a strong key. It's not. It's the smallest one. Okay? So this whole thing is asking you to, you know, both zoom out but also zoom in. Okay? Is asking you to just be quiet. You know, be in quiet, be in silence. Listen to yourself, to your inner voice. Okay? Value these still days. Okay? Value this moment of emptiness, of darkness. It has a reason, it has a purpose, and it's not a bad thing. Okay? So enjoy yourself with the little things. Don't try to get yourself more work. Don't try to open a heavy door with a strong and lots of work key, okay? That is not the way you're going to get there. And I feel like perhaps this comes from a, you know, from even your education. And your parents have always been the type of person like, hey, work hard if you want to get far. Yeah, but sometimes you need to work smarter, not harder. Okay? That's where I'm trying to get to. And that's where I feel like your spirit guides are trying to get you. Is into working smarter, not harder. This is not the moment to work harder. You're going to get the moment to do that. Okay? But right now, breathe and just be. Be there. Be here. Appreciate this moment where nothing is happening. Okay? I really feel like you need to rest. You need to stop. You need to just, I don't know, just change something in your habits. Because I feel like you're pressuring the energy, and that is not going to facilitate new beginnings to come through, okay? So let's pull here some timing for you. Okay. It's interesting that not a lot of timing is coming through, and I feel like it's because you need to let go of a little bit of this control and really focus on the present moment. We do have the 9 and the 18th of a month though. But it's interesting that we have unclear timing. And essentially, just prepare for celebration. Because I feel like you're pressuring the energy so much that the timing is even getting a little bit faded and mixed up. Okay? And I feel like the moment you let this breathe, things flow very, very fast. Okay? So don't focus on timing. We have the 9 and the 18th here has a little guideline, but don't focus on timing. Just get ready to celebrate. In the meantime, rest. Appreciate the little things. Appreciate the darkness, the stillness, the quiet. Okay? And work smarter, not harder. I really get this. Okay? I feel like you're doing too much. You're doing way too much. Okay? So I hope this reading made sense in some sort of way. If it did, don't forget to smash like button for me and subscribe if you haven't already. I would really love to have you here. And if you're interested in getting access to exclusive readings, other content, again, Patreon is the place to be. The link is going to be down below. And now they're there in the description box. Definitely have a look at my decks, merch, and journals, and my tarot course. Okay? So I love you very much. I wish you the best, and hopefully we'll talk very soon.